Lovely day, isn't it?
Tis that.
Are you here on holiday, or...?
No. I live here.
Oh, it's only good. I say, there's our sheep, aren't they? Yes, of course I thought so. Why are they up in the trees?
A fair question, and one that in recent weeks has been much on my mind. It's my considered opinion that they're nesting.
Nesting? Like birds?
Exactly. Birds is the key to the old problem. It's my belief that these sheep are labouring under the misapprehension that they're birds. Observe their behaviour. Take for a start the sheep's tendency to hop about the field on their back legs. Now witness their attempts to fly from tree to tree. Notice they do not so much fly as plummet. Observe, for example, that ewe in that oak tree. She is clearly trying to teach her lamb to fly. Talk about the blind leading the blind.
But why do they think they're birds?
Another fair question. One thing is for sure, a sheep is not a creature of the air. It has enormous difficulty in the comparatively simple act of perching. As you see. As for flight, its body is totally unadapted to the problems of aviation. Trouble is, sheep are very dim. And once they get an idea into their heads, there's no shifting it.
But where did they get the idea from?
From Harold. He's that sheep over there under the elm. He's that most dangerous of animals, a clever sheep. He's the ringleader. He's realised the sheep's life consists of standing around for a few months and then being eaten. And that's a depressing prospect for an ambitious sheep. He's patently hit on the idea of escape.
Why don't you just get rid of Harold?
Because of the enormous commercial possibilities should he succeed.
And what exactly are the commercial possibilities of avine aviation?
Bonsoir, ici nous avons les diagrammes modernes du mouton anglo-français. Ce n'est pas le bon chemin, et pas le propos, le vestibule. Maintenant, quand le U lève le bas, comme ça, nous avons dans la tête le cabine. Ici, où se trouve le petit capitaine anglais, Monsieur Trabshaw.
Be fine, whatever you are.
D'accord. Maintenant, je vous présente mon collègue, le pouf célèbre, Jean-Brian Jadabadi.
Maintenant, j'ai le mouton, mais je vois la vis à l'aise, j'ai le mouton de l'antique, pendant les wheels, bon,
les wheels, ici.
C'est formidable, n'est-ce pas? Et bon, où? Après, je suis allé, la machine, de la machine, de l'avion, de la derrière le mouton, bon. Tchouk, tchouk, tchouk.
Merci beaucoup.
Suivez la piste.
Tais-toi, bien.
Pardon.
Mais, où sont les bagages? Ou le voyageur?
Le voyageur.
Casse pas. Merci. Le voyageur. Les bagages. Ils sont ici.
Premier classe, troisième bagage. Ah, maintenant, quand la tête est comme ça, la tête est comme ça, la tête est comme ça. Démonstration fantastique. Suis-toi. Un, deux, trois.
How do you get on with these French people?
Oh, very well.
So do I.
Me too.
Service mistake. Yes.
Oh, yes, I like them. I mean, they think well.